Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Shariel. If you're new and if you're returning, thank you for coming back. Because of our lifestyles nowadays, the culture that's being pushed, and what some call an agenda, we have become desensitized to sex, especially in America. We are bombarded by sex and sexually charged content on every single level, whether you open your phone to go to social media, whether you watch a movie, a TV show, music, a lot of things are sexually centered and charged, and it's affected us to the point where we think this act is no longer sacred. It doesn't matter. It's an exchange for both parties or just one party to enjoy themselves. And I 100% disagree with that. And I truly know that sex is not casual. This is part one, and I have 4 points in this video that I'll get into after my intro. As human beings, we're naturally intrigued and excited about intercourse. I'm going to call it that from now on because, you know, YouTube is sensitive about certain words. It's enticing, it's a dangerous aspect to it, and you know, people just want to have fun. And I totally get it. We're honestly made to do it, but under certain circumstances, and that's what I believe. I don't believe you're supposed to just be willy-nilly all around town. But like I said in my intro, when you open your phone, what do you see? You see content centered around this. A lot of streamers and content creators are making videos centered around rizzing somebody up and, you know, getting them to be with you later on in the night.
Nice to meet you. I'm Key.
Key. Mm-hmm. All right, so I get a handshake and a hug.
Yeah.
What you like to do for fun?
I can literally cook anything. So what you trying to try?
You. I'm trying to try you.
You.
First time?
Yeah.
You gotta go.
You ready? Come on. Wait.
No.
Wait. I feel like this is too fast. Let's...
Okay.
Yeah.
A lot of people exchange stories with their coworkers about their hookups, and a lot of us have group chats, whether it's with the guys or with the girls, about who we're dealing with and even sending pictures. And that's where I want to talk about the real aspect of this act, because it will change your life, and a lot of the times not for the better. The first reason why it's not casual is because it can cause addiction. Like I said, because this has been normalized, corn isn't taboo. Back in the day, people used to have the magazines and had their little stash spot, or they had DVDs or whatever, or you watch it secretly on your phone. But now it's so out in the open. Women openly talk about that they watch it. Men talk about it with their friends. What's their favorite site? Who's their favorite corn star? And especially with OF taking over in 2020, even though it's dwindled down, it's still very common to just show your body for money or just watch other people's bodies and what they're doing with it. People don't realize the effect that corn has on your brain.
Vincent asks, why is pornography bad?
Oof, why is bad? You are getting false dopamine hits, like working out, that's a dopamine hit.
Right.
Making love to your spouse, that's a good dopamine hit, right? Doing a hard day's work and feeling accomplished, that's a good dopamine hit. Watching secretly because you don't want to be found, because you'll feel guilt and shame, and getting a dopamine hit, you're conditioning yourself to get dopamine out of negativity, negative things, number one. And number three, and this has recently been found in the last 12 months, there's something called induced erectile dysfunction. Now, young kids, teens, kids in their 20s and their 30s are unable to get an erection because they're so used to watching a porn scene that is so exaggerated, mm-hmm. so over the top, that has released so much intense dopamines when you're watching a threesome, foursome. And I don't judge you, I've been down that path, but I stopped.
And someone that comes to mind for me is Lamar Odom. He has been open in the media about his struggle with corn addiction and intercourse addiction and how it's dramatically affected his life. He's lost his wife all the way to almost losing his life because of this addiction.
Lamar says he went to the Love Ranch, a Las Vegas brothel, to escape the fear of losing it all.
I was just thinking about trying to go have fun.
You weren't thinking?
I wasn't thinking.
After a four-day bender, he was found unresponsive. 12 seizures, 6 strokes. His heart stopped twice.
Our culture is very anti-self-discipline. So if you're addicted to sleeping with people, if you're addicted to watching things, if you're addicted to toys, a lot of women are addicted to toys, it's not seen as a bad thing. It's like, it's for pleasure, it's pleasuring yourself. But what is it really costing you when you're always doing these things? It's costing you energy, it's costing you time. A lot of the times it warps men's brains. You obviously always looked at women as attractive and, you know, you might picture things in your head, but now you've twisted your brain to just be a pervert. A lot of men are perverts. A lot of women have become desensitized because now they're watching the videos too. Even if they're not with a guy at the moment, they're using the toys, and the toys could never do what a man can do, which can change your experience with a man, which is not good either. And to know if you're addicted or not, would you be able to stop for 2 weeks? Cold turkey. If the answer is no, you're addicted to intercourse, or you're addicted to corn, or both. And a lot of people don't see this as a problem, but it does affect your life. My second point of why this is not casual is because intercourse can bring a lot of drama in your life. I'm somebody who truly enjoys peace, and I've just noticed a lot of people that have chaotic lives, some of them it's because they're having, you know what, people are sharing partners with a bunch of other people. They're fighting over men.
What he told me is that he told you he's with me. Do you understand that Peter has a family?
I knew that Peter had a son.
How do you think that it's possible that we're living together as a roommate situation when you know that we have children?
I really feel bad. I feel guilty knowing what I know now that you're still with him like that. It's not just that we're each other. We love each other.
Well, I'm sorry to tell you, but I know that he loves me.
I can prove it.
Let's see it. Give it here. Let's prove it.
You want me to tell you something too?
I'm his wife, and ain't nothing fake about that.
And some men will delete another man over a woman. It's happened a lot of times. And it's really scary because we just don't realize how much drama this brings when you're with somebody who's not your husband or your wife. And I get it. People get mad when you talk about marriage. But at the end of the day, if you're in a healthy marriage, a marriage where you're faithful, you don't have these issues. Being a sneaky link is now more popular than being in an actual committed relationship. And that's just a sad state that we're in. So many people act like they're unfazed. I don't need a title. I don't care what they're doing when they're not with me. But at the same time, you're stalking them on social media. When you guys are hanging out, you're looking over at their phone to make sure they're not texting any other girls or she's not dealing with other dudes. And when they walk away, you're looking in their phone and their DMs and trying to find any evidence if they're sleeping with somebody else. And that's how you know you are bothered and you do care, because this is not casual. You are becoming one. You are letting that person enter your body, or you're entering their body. And most of the time it affects women more. Most of the time it's women sharing the same baby daddy. Most of the time it's women competing for the love of one man. Most of the time women look dumb because of who they're sleeping with, and that person is sleeping with a bunch of other women. That is just causing all this drama. Not to mention when men don't have self-discipline, like I talked about in my first point, when you are addicted to this and you have no discipline, men end up having babies on who they're truly with, even their wives. And we've seen this so many times before, because you can't keep it in your pants. Now your wife has to deal with a side baby, or your girlfriend has to deal with a side baby, and that's embarrassing, and that causes drama. And don't let it spill out on social media to now everyone subbing each other, putting up different memes and different sayings and all this other stuff, and trying to take pictures and prove points of, oh, he's with me right now, or she's with me. Like, this is embarrassing, guys. Having to physically fight as an adult over somebody that you're sleeping with and you're truly not even together. What is the point of that? What's the point? And it's all because you're sleeping with this person. It is a big deal. It causes drama. Not to mention popping tires, baseball bats to windshields. I took a Louisville slugger to all those type of things happen, all that type of drama happens when people are sleeping around. Let's be for real. The third reason this is not casual is because you can get pregnant and have a kid. I don't know why people act surprised or shocked when they get pregnant after they do it with somebody. I'm like, do you not know it's called procreation? Because you're creating a human being. Your body doesn't know you don't want to have a baby when you do it with someone. The body's on go. The stuff is coming out, it's reaching the egg, and then the egg develops. And with whatever choice you make, your life is changed forever once you get pregnant.
Leave them babies where the they at. I don't care how good the Peter Wacker is. I don't care that he told you he gonna look out for you, because they be lying. And no, I'm not projecting. I'm living it. So let me save somebody before they make the same mistake I did. I don't care how good it is. If you know you're not in a place to have no children, don't do it. Get up. Matter of fact, stay celibate, because that's what I was doing. And as soon as I violated and breached my contract with myself, I got stuck. And love to leave the mamas alone with the babies and going about their life.
And a lot of the time, because we're in a society that is really not pro-marriage anymore, people are having kids with boyfriends they've only been with for a few months, people that don't really love them, or hookups and sneaky links. And this is causing single parent households. This is causing broken homes. I can account for this because I come from a single parent home. The sibling I grew up with under my mother's roof were very close, but the half siblings I have that we didn't grow up in under the same roof, we're not close like that. And it's because it's hard to garner relationships when you're in different states or different cities and different households. And that's just not the way things are supposed to be. God designed it for us to be a family unit, not to be separated and have a bunch of different dads or different moms. And also, being pregnant by somebody who doesn't love you or care for you or isn't really with you is hard emotionally on the mother that's about to give birth. Pregnancy changes your hormones, it changes your body, it changes how things sit, you may get stretch marks, you swell up. It's a lot. So to be doing that and calling it casual, it's not casual, because your entire body's transforming. And sometimes your body doesn't go back to how it used to be. That's not a bad thing, but it is a real thing. And when you're going through this journey alone, especially for the first time, it can be traumatic. It can be devastating. Going to appointments alone, ultrasounds alone, having gender reveals alone, baby showers by yourself because the person doesn't want to be seen with you that you guys are having a baby together. It's just, that's not how things are supposed to be. When a woman is pregnant, she's supposed to be adorned. She's supposed to be pampered. The man's supposed to be hand and foot on her. I'm not saying he should be her slave, but if someone's carrying your child, that's supposed to be special. And I'm seeing it so many times because we're just casually sleeping with people. We're getting pregnant, having babies, and then having a totally terrible experience.
Never experienced bliss through pregnancy. All of my pregnancies had trauma attached to them. Births had trauma attached to them. So having this space and this opportunity to bring life into the world with someone who loves and adores me and is also going to love and adore this child in the process, and you know, all of those things, it's just it's a blessing.
And not to mention, some women are not fit to be mothers, and that doesn't make you a bad person, but it can sometimes lead to children being neglected, so then they're traumatized from their childhood, or children can end up in foster care. And then they're going from home to home because somebody casually, as they say, decided to sleep with somebody one night. And now this child's life is altered forever. And the fourth reason and the last point of this video of why this is not casual is because this can create hardship. When I talk about hardship, I'm not just referring to if you have a child and, you know, your expenses go up, but intercourse can create hardship in general, but I'll first touch upon, if you have a child, the hardships that can create. We all know when you have a child, the expenses just go up. You have many things that you need to cover, whether it's with another partner helping or you're by yourself. And in this economy and the way things are going, this is very hard to deal with, especially if you casually lay down with someone and thought it wasn't a big deal, and now your life has been turned upside down. I know women that have 2 to 3 jobs, working all types of shifts, and they're still barely making it to take care of their children. And not just to mention women, but if you're a young man and you got somebody pregnant, now there's hardship because some men feel guilty, like they need to stay with the girl, even if they're not attracted to her, but they don't want, or they were never really with her, but now that the kid is in the picture, they feel they need to stay together. I see a lot of people that are faking the funk, staying together, living together for the kid, and that's just never good, because at the end of the day, it's your life, so you need to choose you. Of course, choose your child, but you need to be happy. And when your kid gets older, kids can tell when their parents don't really love each other and they're not into each other, and that's going to affect your child's view of being with somebody. They may think it's not really possible, so they shouldn't even try. Not only are you heartbroken when you don't have help with your child, but you can just be heartbroken because you're sleeping with all these people, especially when it comes to us ladies. We sleep with men sometimes to feel loved, to get attention, and the more people you sleep with, the more you're giving of yourself, and that can create heartbreak once you're ghosted, you're ignored, you're only hit up for certain things, and you're not wifed up, nobody really wants to be with you. That does create heartbreak, whether people want to admit it or not, and you start getting older, and you're like, will I ever get married? And you turn into a one-trick pony to where you're doing all these tricks and flips and hanging from chandeliers, and the men still leave. And one of the biggest things that I see hardship-wise with people that casually do this act is they veer off from achieving their goals. A lot of people think you have all this time in the world to be who you want to be and achieve what you want to achieve, but it's not true. There truly is a window of opportunity, and that window can close on you if you're distracted because you're trying to get in between somebody's legs, especially for the men, because your testosterone's through the roof. So if you're getting some all the time and you love it there, you might not finish your CDL license on time, your real estate license on time. You may be slow to doing your studies, so your GPA is getting affected in high school or college. It can just be a huge distraction. If you're an athlete, male or female, you can be distracted from training because you're always on your back or have somebody else on their back. It's not good. A lot of people are distracted because they're doing this casually, and you miss out on who you're supposed to be, how great you could have been, because you're a horn dog. So now you're creating hardships for your future because you're not handling what you need to handle in the present. And a lot of that stuff causes regret. And some people, their regrets never die down and they never live it down, and they always beat themselves up. And it's all because you couldn't stop casually doing things with people and locking in and focusing on yourself. That's just one regret you don't want to have because you could have avoided it. And for the fellas, when you also have a child with a woman that you don't really want to be with, and say you don't stay, she might put you on child support. So now things are automatically getting taken out of your check. And now your money's getting tight, all because you wanted to sleep with somebody. It's just not worth it. So those are my first 4 points of why this is not a casual act. Whether you agree or not, I'm gonna say what I have to say. If you like my video, give me a thumbs up. I hope I made you think about this in a deeper way. Part 2 will be coming out next. If you'd like to, you can subscribe to me, turn on the bell notifications to see right when I post, and share this with your friends. Thank you so much for watching. You are appreciated.